What is up, Facebook and Worcester Square, Little Italy, New Haven? How you guys doing tonight? Hope everybody had a fantastic Thanksgiving. We're in the festive mood here on Sunday Sauce Pot Live. This is our last show of the year. We will be back after January 1st with a whole bunch of new guests and new agenda and all kinds of fun stuff is lined up in 2021 for you guys. So we hope you will stay tuned. And you can find out all about what's going on with Sunday Sauce Pot by liking Sunday's Sauce Pot on Facebook. So if you haven't liked our Facebook page yet, please go check us out and like us. So it's Christmas time in East Haven. If you guys haven't noticed the video I posted in the group, I made an updated video to the classic Christmas in East Haven, a parody to the Silver Bells song that came out in the early 90s. So if you want to check out the video, the new video to this classic song, you can scroll the group, scroll the wall of the group, or you can go to my brand new Rumble page, rumble.com Sundays Sauce Pot, rumble.com/Sundays Sauce Pot, and you'll find the video and a couple other videos that I posted on there. I'm trying to veer away from YouTube, so Rumble is the new YouTube. And my good friend Paulie Ferro, he created an intro and an outro for my videos. Did an excellent job. I'm really, really happy with it. I've been getting some really good feedback about the intro to the videos. So again, go check me out on rumble.com / Sundays Sauce Pot. And Sundays is plural. So before we get to our guest tonight, we are paying tribute to the Rat Pack. This is going to be a great show. Our guest is coming in from California tonight. So you're going to love Dennis Urbistondo. I hope I said that name right. I met Dennis through the Quarantine Karaoke Facebook group, and I think you guys are going to like him. He does a really good job of the Rat Pack. So, first announcement I'd like to tell you guys about. I tagged her in this video because I hope she's watching, and she's a member of the Worcester Square, Little Italy, New Haven Facebook group, and she's also from East Haven. Shelly Slater has a 34-year-old special needs brother who is mentally 10 years old, and he's been in the hospital for almost a year now. Shelly is trying to make this Christmas a very special one for her brother. She's asking everybody, please, to add Andrew to your Christmas card list. When you're writing out Christmas cards this year, just send Andrew a Christmas card. If you know Shelly, you can contact her, or you can send the Christmas card to Andrew Apuzzo, 109 George Street in East Haven, Connecticut, 06512. You know, it'll mean a lot to the kid. It'll brighten his day, brighten his Christmas spirits, you know, being bedridden at this time of year for a person is not not something that anybody wants to experience. So If you write out Christmas cards, please remember to include Andrew Apuzzo. And again, you can contact Shelly Slater from East Haven for more information about that. So without further ado, we are going to welcome our special guest of this evening, Dennis Urbistondo.
Yeah.
Sunday Sauce Pot Live. Dennis is a singer, a photographer from originally from San Francisco, California. Dennis, I need you to turn on your camera. Turn on your video camera.
Yeah.
We can hear you, but we can't see you.
All right. Yeah. There we go.
Hey.
Hey, Marty.
Dennis. Welcome to the show, buddy. How's it going in California?
It's beautiful here. It's about 70 degrees outside and it's blue skies and I couldn't ask for more. We went for a nice little walk before I came on and I'm ready. I just wanted to say, Marty, thank you. What an honor it is to, sing for you guys, the Worcester Square Little Italy, New Hampshire group. New Haven, Connecticut and East Haven, right?
There you go.
All right. So, very good.
Yeah, I appreciate you. You know, I like your videos in the quarantine karaoke group. And, I'm glad that you could take time and be part of our group tonight.
Oh, so, like I said, what an honor. Thank you.
Do you know, everybody knows what tomorrow is, Dennis, right? You know what tomorrow is?
Let's see. What is it? Monday? What's tomorrow, Kelly?
Yes, Monday. It's Cyber Monday.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, but what a lot of people don't know is tomorrow, November 30th, is Stay Home Because You Are Well Day. Are you going to take advantage of this?
I haven't thought about it yet. We'll see.
Everybody needs a personal day to just escape reality and do whatever it is you want to do. And tomorrow is that day. Tomorrow, November 30th, Thomas and Ruth Roy of Well Cat Holidays created Stay Home Because You Are Well Day.
Wow.
So thank you to them guys. And if my boss didn't get mad at me, I would definitely go ahead and take advantage of it.
Well, I'm my own boss, so I can do whatever I want.
There you go. All right. So what do you enjoy more, Dennis? You enjoy singing or taking pictures?
Oh, singing. Well, it was about a toss up, but now I'm not doing as many pictures because of COVID. Thank you. But so I'm able to sing a lot more. So I go on a quarantine karaoke, the place, the bar where I usually sing. We haven't been done that in 8 months. And I thought I would really miss that. But, I get to sing more on quarantine karaoke. Let me just tell you, Marty, a little story. I've just been singing for a few years, like 4 years. When I met my girlfriend Kelly about 5 years ago, she said, I go to karaoke every Friday and Saturday night. And I go, well, that's your thing. You know, you go to your karaoke and I'll see you after that. And so, several months went by and one day she came up to me. She says, well, I was there at the bar and I keep telling all my friends about my new boyfriend, but they've never seen you. And, they figured, well, he doesn't come out on the weekends because he's married. And so I thought, well, I don't want them to think that. So I told her, I says, well, I'll start coming out and, but I'm not going to sing. And so she said, okay. So I came to the bar, and I'm watching the singers and about 3 months go by. And there were some really good singers, but then there were some really bad singers. So right. I thought this one guy's just butchering Sinatra. And so I said, oh my God, I could probably, outdo this guy. So I knew a lot of Sinatra songs. And so one day it was my birthday actually. And I went into the bar and just like I would with everybody else, have my glass of wine. And I'd slip my little slip of paper to the DJ, the KJ, and didn't tell anybody that I was gonna sing. And then the next thing she knows, she goes, Dennis, you're up. So I came up and everybody's like, what? And so she played Sinatra Under My Skin. I killed it. And then after I was done, they were all like, what? This guy's better than we are. Where have you been doing? And so the rest is history. And I knew that ever since that that one song, I'd have to sing after that and so on and so on. So the rest is history anyway. So, but I'm a Sinatra and Dean Martin guy.
So is that where they deemed you Filipino Dino?
Yes. Yes, yes.
But, are you Philippine?
Yeah, yeah, Filipino. And, well, they also dubbed me the Silver Fox. But, you know, so it was...
Because of your hair?
Yeah, the hair. All so, right. But, you know, I don't mind what they call me. I'll get up there and belt it out.
Just don't call you late for dinner, right?
There you go. There you go, Marty.
So what's your favorite song that you like the most by Frank Sinatra and Dean Martin?
My go-to song for Sinatra is Under My Skin, still is. The very first song I'd ever sang. And even till this day, it's still my favorite song. I think it's one of the coolest songs Sinatra ever sang. You know, people go, why don't you sing Strangers in the Night? Let me tell you, Sinatra hated that song. He called that a piece of, and he said, that's the worst effing song he'd ever heard. Believe it or not.
Oh my gosh, you're killing me. That was my nonny's favorite song.
Oh, he said that, you know, and even My Way. He wasn't crazy about My Way. And another
that one I knew. I knew he didn't like My Way too much.
And My Way, believe it or not, around the karaoke bars around the world, there were 6 deaths because for whatever reason, like cultish reasons, you know, if you didn't sing My Way correctly, people would get in fights. I mean, bad brawls. And it ended. Some of them ended up in you know, killings from the song My Way. So a lot of the bars banned that song from their playlist, My Way. So go figure.
All right. So what's the first song you're going to do for Worcester Square tonight, Dennis?
Under My Skin, Sinatra.
All right. So, all right.
So a little disclaimer, I was having a little bit of technical difficulty here. So after this song, tell me if it sounded fine, if I need to turn something down or whatnot, and I'll do that, okay?
All right, sounds good, Dennis. Thanks a lot.
I'm using my iPhone for that, which I'm not used to doing, so but it should be okay. So here we go.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you deep in the heart of me. So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you under my skin. I've tried so not to give in, and I said to myself, this affair, it never will go so well. But why should I try to resist when, baby, I know damn well that I've got you under my skin. I'd sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool, you never man win. Use your mentality, wake up to reality. But each time I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. Because I've got you under my skin. I would sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, inside of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats how it yells in my ear. Don't you know, you fool, ain't no chance to win. Why not use your mentality? Get up, wake up to reality. And each time I think just the thought of you makes me stop this before I begin. Cause I've got you under my skin. And I like you under my skin.
Bravo, bravo. So,
the sound all right?
Sounds great, Dennis. I want to say hello to a couple people that are in the chat room there. We got Laura, Johnny Frisco, Excellent Pizza out there, Jeff Keller, Sandy, Ed, Sherry McDonald, everybody. And then the list goes on. I can't see everybody's name. So if you leave a comment, leave Dennis a comment, we can say hello to you guys. We appreciate everybody watching. And also, again, thank you so much for being part of our Facebook group. So, Dennis, what else you got for us tonight?
Oh, let's see. I'm going to do a Dean Martin one right now. And from the Rat Pack era. You know, that's why I sing these songs, because there's nothing like it. And maybe we'll never, ever be anything like it again. You'll never be able to emulate Sinatra, you know, Dean Martin or Sammy, but gosh. So
I'll tell you though, Dennis, there is a group out nowadays, three young guys. They're called Il Volo.
Oh yeah. Yeah. My mom loves that.
Oh, I saw them last year. Really good group of guys. Yeah. So,
You know what Dean Martin's original name was?
I used to know it. I don't know anymore.
You know Paul Cassetti?
Yes.
Yeah, and he changed it like three times. So, but you know, Dean Martin sounded more sophisticated, so they went with that. He was also, like me, a very devout Catholic, said his prayers every night.
Yep.
And I'm a good Catholic boy. I belong to the Italian Catholic Federation of my church. So, yeah. Okay. So now I'm going to take the people back to Vegas right now. Right. Okay. Now I want you to imagine, picture, if you will, the place would be the Sands Hotel, Las Vegas, and Dean Martin and Sammy Davis. And Dean Martin was the star of that show. So here we go. It's going to take a second to open this up.
You know what somebody once said? They said Frank Sinatra used to think he was the star of the show, but Dean Martin knew he was the star of the show.
I heard the same thing, and he's right. They're absolutely right, because Dean Martin would always open all of the Rat Pack shows at the Sands in Vegas, and for good reason. And that's what you're going to hear now, is Dean Martin's opening song, and it's called "I Love Vegas."
All
right. You guys ready?
We're ready.
All right, here we go. Now, the lyrics are going to be a little dated, so, you know, just to let you know.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Sands Hotel proudly presents the star of our show, direct from the bar, Dean Martin.
All right.
Drink to me only, that's all I ask, and I will drink to you. I don't care if the sun don't shine, I do my drinking in the evening time when I'm in Las Vegas. You can sit in the sun and camp. I am a color from a sunray lamp when I'm in Las Vegas. I love the laughs and love the life. There's fun of every kind. Next time I come, I'll bring my wife. Well, to that, if I lose my mind, a wife in Vegas, take my advice, like going to China with a sack of rice. But I love Las Vegas. I love Vegas in the summer. Ooh, I love it in the fall. I love Vegas, may I say that, is a gasser. Yeah, I love Vegas like it's Egypt, and I am Nasser. I love Vegas every moment. Ooh, it's my favorite atmosphere. I love Vegas. Why do I love Vegas? Because my money's here. I love Vegas when I'm winning. Ooh, I love it when I lose. I love Vegas like the army loves its manuals. I love Vegas like Sinatra loves Jack Daniels. I love Vegas every moment. Oh, Mr. Entrada, I must cheer. Thank you, smart. Oh, I love Vegas. Ah, the labor, do I love Vegas? Because my blood is here. Ooh, I love Vegas when I'm loaded. I love Vegas when I am not. I love Vegas, just like Khrushchev loves being indignant. More than even my wife Kelly loves being pregnant. I love Vegas every moment. When I leave, I shed a tear. Oh, I love Vegas. Jesus Christ, do I love Vegas? I'll make it good and clear. It's because my girl's right here.
Cheers.
How was that? I love Vegas. You ever heard that one before?
I never heard that one before. Dennis, have you ever been there?
Oh, yeah. My family used to live in Vegas, so I was there a lot. One time I thought I might move there, but I'm glad I didn't.
Nah, I think if I lived there, I'd be homeless.
Yeah, really? Yeah, lost wages. I've got to show you something here, Marty, real quick. You know, I'm a photographer, and I saw Sinatra, 1978, at the Circle Star Theater, and I shot this photo of him.
Really?
Yeah, pretty good, huh?
You got that close to him?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, and this was at the time when he was, like getting a lot of press for punching photographers and paparazzi. So I took a chance. I went out into the aisle, and he's like 10 feet away from me, looking right at me in the eyes, and click, click, and then it was a circle, you know, so we'd go around, and I wait till he comes back, click, click. So that picture, I mean, I've got a whole bunch, and I found the slides. I'm gonna make a bunch of these. So, anyway,
what did you pay for a ticket to see him back then?
You know, it was my girlfriend's parents at the time gave me their tickets. So I don't know. I just said, they go, you want to go see Sinatra? I'm like, yeah. Jeez.
How was that, Dennis? I mean, you got to live an experience that some people dream about. So how
was it? Was like a dream. I mean, all I could sit there and just watch him sing. And, you know, that he was 64 already at the time, about my age. And his voice was starting to crack a little bit. But, You know, it didn't matter because I knew I was in the presence. You know, like they say, when God sneezes, what do you say? You say, Sinatra, bless you. And so that's how, he, you know, the how we, you know, feelings I had. He was just the greatest and still is. Well, Dean Martin's up there with him, too.
Did anybody open up for Frank Sinatra or he was the?
Yeah. Yeah. He had a comedian named something Henry or Henry. It was pretty funny, too. Really funny comedian. But when Sinatra came on, it was like, that's it. You know. We're not worthy. You know, he's only like 5'7", 5'8". So.
Really?
Yeah, he's not a tall guy. He would wear the elevator shoes to make him about 5'9", or 5'10". But yeah, he was a short guy.
So a couple more people jumped in here. Remo, Charlotte, Carla Miller, Anthony Moscato. We got a bunch of people watching. Lori Ann. You guys, leave us a comment. Ed. Donna, leave us a comment. Let me know what you think of Dennis. I think he's a great singer. And from that picture, oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Excellent photographer.
And you can see the Rat Pack picture behind me. I don't know if you can see it very well, but
yeah.
Yeah.
I think I got that same picture. I got one from a casino. It's a picture from a casino.
Yeah.
I got Dean Martin and Sammy Davis and Frank Sinatra all together.
Yeah.
All right, so we got time for one more, Dennis. What do you think you're going to do here?
Okay, I'll do one more Dean Martin. Okay, let's see. One that everybody loves. Okay, let's see.
One that everyone loves. Well, my guess, that's either That's Amore. There's so many. There's just so many.
Everybody loves somebody.
There you go.
Yeah, okay.
That's a good one.
Yeah. I thought, you know, I was going to do Ain't That a Kick in the Head, but somebody sang it on the Worcester side a couple of weeks ago. So I thought, oh, I'll just change it up. Okay, here we go.
All right.
Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody falls in love somehow. Something in your kiss just told me that sometime is now. Everybody finds somebody someplace. There is no telling where love may appear. Something in my heart keeps saying my someplace is here. If I had it in my power, I'd arrange for every girl to have your charm. Then every minute, every hour, everyone would find what I found in your arms. Everybody loves somebody sometime. And although my dream was overdue, your love made it all worth waiting for someone like you. If I had it in my power, I'd arrange for every girl to have your charm. Then every minute, every hour, everyone would find what I found in your arms. Everybody loves somebody sometime. And although my dream was overdue, your love made it all worth waiting for someone like you.
All right. So you got a compliment on your jacket there from my old friend, Laura.
All right. Thanks, Laura. Yeah, a little festive and a little Vegas at the same time.
You're looking very dapper there this evening.
But I got jeans on, you know, so, you know, it's semi-formal.
All right, so Dennis, how can somebody find you? I tagged you in the video so they can go to this video and they can find your name like that. But
yeah, Facebook, you know, is my, you know, you can find me either Facebook or YouTube. Just use my first and last name. So, you know, it'll be on your site. And then there's another Facebook.
So you do have a YouTube channel?
Yeah. Just my first and last name.
If you want to find Dennis, guys, Sherry McDonald says you're awesome.
Thank you.
If you want to find Dennis on YouTube, you can go to Dennis. Like I said, I tagged him in this video, but it's Urbistondo.
Yeah.
Urbistondo. Can find him on YouTube. And also join the quarantine karaoke group.
Yes.
You'll find Dennis there amongst 700,000 other talented singers.
Yeah, 700,000, yep.
Sandy Durso says, good voice, and she loves my hat.
Well, nice. I'm glad that New Haven was, like this guy. So good. Thank you.
Yeah, the Filipino Dino.
Filipino Dino, there you go. And one thing about Dean Martin, you know, he looked like he was drunk on stage, but that was apple juice. It was all just an act.
It was all an act. That's what I heard.
Apple juice. So there you go.
All right, Dennis, thanks a lot for being part of Sunday Sauce Pot. And wish you a Merry Christmas, okay?
Thanks,
stay
Marty.
Safe out there.
All right. Take care, Marty.
Okay. Ciao, Dennis. All right, that was a great guest, Dennis. I tell you, you find some really talented people in quarantine karaoke. That's an excellent Facebook group for you guys to check out. My old and dear friend Riri told me about that group, and I absolutely love quarantine karaoke Facebook group. At the end of the day, right before bed, you do a little scrolling. And I'm telling you, there's some people that they dress up in there and they really get into these videos. So you need to check that group out, Quarantine Karaoke. A couple more things before I say goodnight to you guys tonight. One more time, Shelly Slater from East Haven, her brother is mentally 10 years old, but he's actually 34 years old. So he's been in the hospital for a year, and Shelly's trying to get people to mail her brother some Christmas cards. So guys, if you're mailing out Christmas cards, set aside one for Andrew Apuzzo, 109 George Street, East Haven, Connecticut, 06512, and it'll lighten up his day. One more thing I want to let you guys know about is a Facebook page. If you're all about Worcester Square, you got to check out Worcester Square Blossom Blog. Bart Connors is a member of our group here, and he's the administrator of the Worcester Square Blossom Blog Facebook page. Lots of photos, videos, birds, banter, Yale, and of course, New Haven Beats. So what information would you like me to post, Sherry McDonald? I'll post whatever you want me to post. About the boy, I will. I'll post that about the boy, Andrew Apuzzo, for the Christmas cards. And again, don't forget to check me out on Rumble. Rumble.com/SundaysSaucePot. You can see the link. You can see the video for the new video for Christmas in East Haven. So, guys, thank you so much for watching Sunday Sauce Pot and being part of our Facebook group. Like I said, this is the last show I'm doing for the year, And then hopefully I'm going to come back with a bang for 2021. I'm trying to get a hold of some very special guests, recognizable guests, and I'm hoping to take the show to the next level. Whatever's going to happen is going to happen. So I want to wish you guys a very, very Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. I hope you guys stay safe and stay blessed. Thanks for watching. Who loves you, baby?